Hello guys, today we are going to learn chain stitch. Chain stitch is the most easiest stitch up till now. So in chain stitch we start from a point, and from this point we are going to take a small loop which is going to end again over here, and we are going to start the another loop from here. So these are completely full of loops. So one after the other there will be loops. So in this manner it is formed, so it is called as chain stitch. Now I'm going to show you this chain stitch on the cloth. So as usual I had took a thread, cotton thread of two threads, and I'm going to do a straight line. First I'm taking a needle outside from a point, specific point, and I am holding the thread in my right thumb so that I will form a semicircle or a loop before I start my stitch. When next to this thread I am going to put my needle down and take it in front to how much big I am requiring the stitch. So this is how I am going to do it. Slowly I am pulling it to complete the loop. After this, the second loop or the second chain I am going to put is, I am going to put the needle just next to it and a little distance forward. This is how I form the chain. If I want to do it on a design, I will take small loops. As much small I can, we can take the loops as much small we want. So now I am showing you the small loops. Just one thing, in a particular design, when we start with a design or when we start with your embroidery, when we start with chain stitch, all the chains should come in a specific, at a specific distance. Don't do it one big and one small. It looks untidy. So this is how the chain stitch is done. While ending up with a chain stitch, the simple thing I have to do is, after this loop, outside this loop, I have to put my needle to the downside, just after the loop. And as usual, I will tie a knot. In chain stitch, I get a straight line. So just this much is about the chain stitch. Our chain stitch is complete. So now I'm going to show you a small tact regarding this chain stitch. On a particular outfit, when I want to put it, or I want to sieve at a point, or I want to alter it, I am going to fold it and I am going to stitch it. But on this point, I can't stitch directly. So even sometimes hemming becomes little difficult at a point. At this time, I am going to do it with chain stitch. For this thing, what we have to do is, we have to take long distance chain stitch or big loops for the chain stitch. Up till here I am stitching it, I am not taking it more further. as my thread is going to get over. Now, as usual, to end up with the stitch, we put the needle down. But in this case, I am not going to put my needle down. Instead of that, I am going to take out my thread from this loop. And I am going to separate every loop from the other. Then slowly I am going to pull the threads that all my loops are going to come out. And this is how I had stitched it. Now you can't see the stitch over there from the front side, but from the back side the stitch is there. And my cloth has been also stitched. So this is a simple tacked chain stitch. And here we complete the topic of chain stitch. Please like and subscribe to my channel, Preeti's Needle and Thread Creations. Thank you.